Super good. Yeah. Yeah.
And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Joe Link, father of Samantha, to do a toast. Woo!
Yeah,
kids that needed help, and she talked about a sad story about a mother and son.
And Jackie or I said something nice to her, and she started crying and talked about how fortunate she was to have such good parents and how life's so unfair for so many other people. Samuel, we're the fortunate ones to have such a lovely daughter. And I'm confident with your compassion and your smarts, you'll be able to make the world better for a lot of other people. This Jake guy, though, I don't know about him. I found out about him when Sammy was a junior in high school. Jackie called me up and said, Sammy had been invited to her junior prom. I said, by who? She said, Jake McDonough. I said, what do you know about the boy? And she says, well, he's a senior. He's a starting point guard on the West Tampa basketball team, and he's really cute. Back in my day, those guys were smooth operators. He's starting to help out already. I immediately thought, Jake the Snake. But Jake came to the house, he came in the doors, and anyone who knows Jake knows he's just a very genuine and good guy. And we liked him right from the get-go. Fast forward 4 years, Jake has graduated from Michigan State University. He's starting his career in Seattle, Washington for Sherman Williams. Sammy's back at the house. She's got one more year to go at State. She's sitting on the couch. I come sit next to her. She ignores me. I ignore her. She pulls out her phone and she makes a FaceTime call to Jake. You know where you can see each other on the phone?
There we go.
I just learned about that yesterday. Gosh, I made a FaceTime call, and I wasn't sure what was going on with these two. You know, she didn't have a ring on his finger when he left to Seattle. I was kind of curious. And, I was listening, I was trying to listen real hard to it. And, I don't hear anything for about 30 seconds, and I look over, and Sammy's just smiling, batting her eyelashes, and she's got this unmistakable look of love in her face. I said, oh my goodness. That Jake McDonough's got her in the palm of his hand. And Sam, that's when you start realizing, think back and, whew. When you were a little girl, you used to grab my hand and walk up and down the steps of our house, cross the street, or he'd grab my hand when he walked in a crowded store or mall. But then I knew it was Jake's turn to walk with you. And that's why this is such a special day. You got the right guy. Finally, I'd like to read an Irish blessing.
Yeah, do it twice, by the way.
As you join the family. And it's one that to you and Jake, and it's one that your grandfather, my father, read to your read at your cousin Amanda's wedding in 2004.
Kids,
remember that, Amanda? May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. May the light of friendship guide your paths together. May the laughter of children grace the halls of your home. May the joy of living for one another trip a smile from your lips, a twinkle from your eye. And when eternity beckons, at the end of a life heaped high with love, may the good Lord embrace you with the arms that have nurtured you the whole length of your joy-filled lives. May the gracious God hold you both in the palm of his hands. And today, may the spirit of love find a dwelling place in your hearts. I want to thank everybody for coming. I'm not going to try and follow that
in
a speech. They chose me because I'm the pious father-in-law. So I just want to pray. Everybody will say a prayer before the meal. And we're thankful for everyone that can be here. We ask God that everybody returning home will return home safely. And we want to bless this marriage. Bless this food that we're about to eat. And we'll say, bless us, our Lord, these thy gifts which we're about to receive. And I bow to thee through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you.